Welcome back to Beat on the Street. You know, Amelia, I hate to insult you. I'd rather pepper you with compliments, but didn't you wear those boots last time?
Nice one, Steve. Today on Beat on the Street, we're talking about salt. And here we have Allie. She's going to talk to us all about salt.
How does salt work in your body? Well, essentially, salt follows water. So if you increase your intake of sodium by too much, it leads to water retention, which none of us wants. However, on the other side of it, if you're not taking enough sodium into your body, it leads to dehydration. Sodium and potassium are two electrolytes that work together to ensure proper fluid balance within your body. They regulate your heartbeat, allowing your muscles to contract. Without this communication system functioning properly, the brain and nervous system can suffer. Getting too much salt in your diet is not a good thing, but make sure to get enough. Table salts are mined from underground deposits and are heavily processed. They're heated to 1200 degrees Fahrenheit, completely altering their natural chemical composition and destroying most of their healthy benefits. It remains a good source of iodine, which is beneficial for people who suffer from thyroid imbalances. However, iodine can also be found naturally occurring in foods like eggs, dairy, seafood of all kinds, and seaweeds. Well, if you think about it, all salts, including table salts, come from some salty body of water. However, some of these deep down salty deposits come from oceans that aren't even in existence today. Himalayan salt, often referred to as pink gold, it's believed to date back to the beginning of Earth's creation. Primal sea, guys. Contains over 84 trace minerals and elements. Obtaining these micronutrients from food is harder than it used to be due to the lack of nutrient-rich soil, but they are still abundant in our Earth's seas. Consuming the proper amount of sea salt can also help your body produce HCl, which is a building block for stomach acid, helping with digestion and the absorption of vitamins and minerals. Celtic sea salt. It's harvested near Brittany, France on the Celtic Sea. It uses a 2,000-year-old method that naturally retains its amazing nutritional properties. Comparable to Himalayan crystal salt in its composition, Celtic sea salt is slightly lower in sodium, but higher in levels of calcium, magnesium, and iron. However, Himalayan sea salt has nearly twice the potassium. Malden salt is an English sea salt with large, thin flakes, beloved by the world's top chefs for its superior quality and great taste. Kosher salt earned its name for its ability to drain blood from meat before consumption, complying with Jewish law. Also, there you have it, salt. Hope you've learned a little bit about it. Maybe with your next meal, take a little pinch of salt. Try something new. Just a little pinch.